Feel me? Some of these comments, I know you don't even like to read, do you? Like, what the hell? Hey, everybody got their own, how can I say it? Everybody got their own way of thinking. But at the end of the day, no matter if you're white, black, right is right, wrong is wrong. That's why it's a good and there's the evil. The devil in your ear is telling you to do all types of fuck shit, bad shit. But the angel in your ear say, no. You have kids. You have a life. You have a... How can I say this? You have a... I don't know. Y'all know what I'm trying to say. Shit. Nah, Maxwell does a great job. Hell yeah. I love Maxwell. All
right, back at you, Chris.
My real shit.
Real look.
Hey, I'm gonna keep up the good work, but this is I'm doing God's work. This is God's work to me. Like, real shit.
God's plan. Fuck do you?
Because for me to just quit everything, like, I even had a little business going. I stopped that, my own business. And who would stop their own business for coming down here and be stressed out every day? I've been stressed up for 82 days.
Man.
And I'm not even gonna lie. As soon as I get out of my car, and this is fact, as soon as I get out of my car, somebody says something that happened, they want me to lead a march, everything. Yeah, see, Tez, that's my Brody. It's my Brody. My Brody for life.
Y'all better know what he's saying.
For life.
He says something that's gonna get you somewhere in life. He says something that's gonna get you where you need to be. He says something that's wisdom and encouragement. Because if you fall for nothing, you're what?
Huh?
Fall for anything.
You feel me?
So most definitely take heed of what he's saying, man. This man been out here going hard, man. Shout out to Maxwell. He been going hard. So a lot of people out here going hard for the cause.
Every day.
And people are losing all type of things out the back of them. People are losing their jobs. People are losing their wives and all type of situations because we down here for the cause. You know what I'm saying?
For the cause, man.
You know what I'm saying? And sometimes you might got people down here that's in bad, you know what I'm saying, bad moves. Or, you know, but still, we can't let that stop us from what we're trying to get accomplished.
No. Being down here is beautiful because you're meeting new people, you seeing new faces, you seeing new personalities, you seeing more love. You feel me? Like, real shit, like, this is the best thing ever happened to me, because this is history, like, for real. Everybody loves me. I love everybody, because I don't give out no negative vibes, no negative name. I'm a positive nigga. You know what I'm saying? I take care of my kids. But God is good, man. Like, real talk. Yeah, come here.
They want you on her.
Feel me? This is our squad. No matter what, who y'all with.
Tell Bruce
this is our squad. This is family.
What up, man? What he said?
From the old generation to the new generation. Man. Feel me? This is a new king right here.
AKA, they call you DMX. They call him DMX. People with the same energy. There you go.
But keep watching every day. But come out here and march with us, man. Feel me?
Facts. It was Breeway or no way, man.
What they say? Breeway or no way.
What they say?
Breeway or no way.
Why does it feel like?
Man, fuck you!
Bro, a white tech show. What are they talking about?
Some negative shit. And look, I'm gonna keep 100 on this too. I don't give a fuck what nobody say about me. I don't give a fuck about nobody. Yeah, they gonna say it. At the end of the day, I know what I'm here for. At the end of the day,
I'm blocked.
At the end of the day, I want justice. At the end of the day, I want change. At the end of the day,
I know you, baby.
I'm gonna lead people to the right direction.
Hey, listen, y'all.
Who is your man? Who is your man?
Listen. Talk to him, Quando.
I'm gonna tell you the guy's honest truth. I ain't out here for justice.
Uh-oh.
You wanna know why? Justice is an after effect, right? Justice is after something happens. We want justice for it. We want them to act right, act accordingly. Like, I want prevention. I don't want this shit to happen no more.
I'm not here for change.
I don't want this shit to happen no more. So knowledge is power, for real, for real. So if we all knowledgeable, if we all know what to do, then let's do it. We gotta act on that. We gotta act on that. Like I ain't trying to yell nobody's name, man. Like I seen this little girl when she was little, like, nigga, y'all tripping. Or I'm tired of yelling names, man. And plus, we don't even know all the names until something like this happens that draws attention to it. So we gotta hold everybody accountable.
Everybody.
Prevention, yes, prevention is what it is. Accountability is all. That's all you gotta do. If you see my man, look, you know how many times my kings tell me I'm fucking up? I don't fuck up too often, but when I do, I want somebody to check me. Cause I'ma check you. I'ma definitely check you if you fucking up. Quit. Tell me when I'm fucking up. For real. Hold each other accountable. It's prevention.
Be the future we hold.
This is our city. Yeah, be the future.
So we gotta stand up for our city.
Facts.
I'ma say it again. This is our fucking city. We need to stand up for our own fucking city.
Woo!
No matter who the fuck you are.
And I'm gonna tell you, listen, check this out. Check this out, man. Look. This is Louisville, man. I've been gone for a minute, you know what I'm saying? I've been gone, but I knew to keep my distance. Don't forget that. But listen. This is Louisville. This is my city. This is my city. This is our city. When I yell our streets, whose streets? Our streets. I mean that. I stand on that. And I don't give a fuck who's out here. I'm in the streets with it. They told us we couldn't march. Where I'm at? I'm in the streets with it. You can stand on the sidewalk. I support it all. But I'm in the streets with it. And I'm going to tell you facts. We ain't standing. We ain't going for none of that bullshit no more. We holding everybody accountable. I don't care if you wear blue. I don't care if you wear a suit. I don't give a fuck if you wear basketballs and a t-shirt. Nigga, I'm holding you accountable if you fuck up. And that's just real shit.
Facts. But, hey, if they know their constitutional laws, we do not have to be on this fucking sidewalk marching. I'm gonna say this again. If Louisville Metro Police Department do anything while we marching, while there's still oncoming traffic while we in the area, that's a fucking lawsuit because that's against our fucking constitutional rights. That's why I say educate yourselves.
Talk
to them. Educate yourselves.
If y'all heard me say
so
it
once. So
come
on out here and march with us. We're gonna march in one lane. Right. If it's three lanes, we're gonna probably march in two. Yep. So that one oncoming traffic, you can go ahead, boo-boo. Go and do what you got to do. Because we really doing this for you.
But for real,
every time we march in here, we going to take over these streets.
If you heard me before, you know. If you know the law, you can break the law. So you gotta be knowledgeable of what the fuck's going on. If you know what's going on, then you know when they fucking you. And you can really, really respond accordingly. Man, you gotta get knowledgeable out here. Tell your kids, teach your kids, show your kids. Man, I respect every person who's out here who is educating themselves. I don't care if it's from the books. I don't care if it's from the streets. I don't care if you ain't touched a book a day in your life. You still are knowledgeable and you still are smart and you still can contain yourself and uphold yourself in a respectful manner. Like, it's all about respect for real, for real.
And
I respect anybody. I respect any man that respect me, but I die for my respect. If you don't know, then you know, nigga, I don't, no disrespect. I do not fuck with no disrespect. And I'm gonna put them paws on you if need be.
In 2020, there's so many different revenues of researching anything.
Facts.
Everybody so should many know different everything. Revenues. Because back then, 52, 53 years ago, they just had a fucking newspaper.
And look, what they did, though.
Look what they did. They still did.
So look what we can do.
Make a stand.
If look what we doing.
That, watch what the
we
fuck
can do
we
so
do.
Much more.
We already made so much with more. The together.
Law. Together, though.
Together, bro.
Curious about how this sounds.
We got four moves right here. You feel me? It ain't about that.
I'm curious about how this sounds.
They put out the information that they want us to know.
Thanks, she got it. But look.
They put information that they want us to know. So what we really got to do is get in tune with ourselves.
Aloha.
You get in tune with your body. You get in tune with your mind.
Self-help.
And black people are naturally the most powerful species on this planet.
We can generate any.
We can generate. We have the power to create.
My grandmother got 13. She got 13 kids. They all different colors. But they all by the same man and woman. Swear to God, we powerful like that. But it ain't even about, it's like I said, it's not us against them. It's us. we have to respect us for anybody else to respect us. You get what I'm saying? Like the word nigga, you gotta understand that it's moved from a different. It ain't just a nigga. It's a word that it's actually, if you look at it in terms of to hear something and be downgraded by a word, and to be able to take that word and reform it into a form of expression of, hey, what's up, or hey, hello, that's powerful. You gotta take what happens to you and change it. Everything you can learn from. You get what I'm saying? So if you learn from life is about learning and understanding.
Yeah.
So everything you can learn from. So once you learn it, you understand it. Nice. And once you understand it, you can share it.
Nice.
So you can't hold it in. If you hold it in, you the problem too.
Live fast or die young.
I bet y'all, I'm gonna quote this fact. Right. And like I said, I've been educating myself every day. Did y'all know, as an African-American people, we are not an American citizen. We are our own fucking citizen.
Whoa.
Did y'all fucking know that?
I ain't know it.
Do your research, because when we get pulled over by any metro government, if we really go through and go forth with it, we don't have to abide by no constitutional laws, because you don't know why? We are our own fucking citizen. We have our own laws.
Mm.
Like I said, you gotta stay woke. I've been reading a little bit too much, but I've been reading. Every African-American male is not no fucking citizen of the United States of America. None. If y'all think I'm lying, go look
so
that
you
shit
saying
up.
You saying it's like the Mexican, they
listen,
not.
Listen, we are our own
citizen. Say it loud!
I'm black and I'm proud!
Say it loud!
Black man.
You gotta do some research and go through some classes.
Yo, right.
You have your own
working on the Samsung
ID when it comes
the Samsung
to,
microphone.
You know, we got the United States ID. Yeah. We'll have our own fucking ID with our pictures on it, and we do not have to obey by no constitutional laws. When it comes to-
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome in to another evening of protests. All right, we're here in Louisville, Kentucky. We're discussing what it means to be black, or something, or the best way to rob someone. I don't know. We're gonna go over to Portland, though. That's our place. We love Portland. We love Zipporah Lomax. Zipporah Lomax, come down, Zipporah. We're gonna look at you, you tweaker bitch. We're gonna follow you around, see where you're at. Are you going to Colonel Sanders Park? I don't know, cultural archivist, Zipporah Lomax, kid-centered march for Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. All right, let's watch some white people protest. Shut up, Blackie. Oh, cute children and moms and white people. Oh, look, just the little cute kids. All right. I agree, Jason. I agree.
We don't have black kids in Portland. They just were outlawed. It just happened. No, I'm kidding. I live in Portland, Oregon. There's no one black. Like, I mean, I say this as someone who's lived in LA and Seattle as well. Like, there's just no black people in Portland. It's a really, really racist city. It just is. God damn it, guys. I'm going to leave you in like 10 minutes to go back to watching my basketball game in the other room, but you guys are all being so... Oh! Look! Strayvon!
That is one of the cutest little masks I've seen.
Yes.
I like your mask.
But only if I am the person that gets to beat up the trans woman.
Oh, little tiny little sign. It's beautiful. Good job.
Because trans are bad. Trans people are evil that want to pee in your bathroom and fuck your kids while they're just trying to do that. Bad. You know what? Free Keith's love. All he was doing was putting a mentally ill person in their place. Woo! Because white people are bad. God, Dr. Voodoo. Figure it out over there on Periscope. Fucking racist.
Hey.
File.
Kendra James.
All right, I'm gonna go.
Kendra James.
I gotta check on my basketball game.
Kendra James. Kendra James. Kendra James.
Thank you.
Good thing I turned the microphone off so no one can hear me discuss how George Soros is paying me all this money to spread disinformation. Fuck.
To be. Tiny little signs some of them are holding are just, and they're like so adorable. Is it all right if I show the little sign? Is it all right if I let my viewers see this little sign? Oh, hi. Did you make that little sign or did Daddy help?
That's really cute. What's it say on the other side? Does it say something on the other side? Did you draw on it? Oh, yeah. It's a nice drawing. Thank you. So, Zipporah Lomax. Or Zippy Lomax. You just look for Zippy Lomax, he'll find me. This is my favorite one. Much nicer than the nighttime.
I just want to say, as someone who lives here in Portland, who is, you know, just streaming these protests, just like you, concerned citizen, watching what's going on, you know, noticing that no one's paying attention. You know, real Portlanders want these people gone. This is the vocal minority. Portland's a city of 1 million people within the surrounding areas. And you're seeing the same 500 to 1,000 people every night march. That's a vocal minority. It's not the actual groundswelling of support. And our city leaders and out into the suburbs are bowing down at these people that don't have an actual, like, look, let's be honest, guys, black lives matter in the respect that they matter the same as any other life. We get that. We're all there. I'm sure most of us have been there for a long time. I don't care. I don't care if you're black. I don't care if you're Hispanic, Mexican, you know, whatever. Asian. The whole gauntlet. But what we don't want is we don't want to be fucking, you know, accosted by these, not these animals. These are children with their fucking stupid-ass parents. You can see the same dead-eyed, stupid bitch look in every one of these women's faces, and you can see the pedophilic look in these men who just are there because they want to fucking get close to these children because they're rapists. They have no God. They have no soul. These are pedophiles and soulless opiate-addicted single mothers raising a generation of lost kids who are going to cut their dicks off or think that they can grow a dick out of their inside labia and all that nasty business down there that fucking women deal with. We're tired. We're tired of this bullshit. We're tired of you fucking thinking that a thousand people are speaking up for everyone. You're not. You're fucking not. Now all we're doing is just shutting down fucking streets for no reason. I mean, not that anything's going on Hawthorne at the moment, because every business is closed because of Kate Brown. This is nonsense. We are raising a generation of heathens. Get out while you can. I'm thinking about moving to like a nice, you know, country where they still fucking have some semblance of respect for the culture. Tahiti. How does Tahiti sound, guys? Mangoes. Better than this shit. Look at these fucking soulless people with the same goddamn rhetoric. Turn the volume back on. It's the same goddamn rhetoric over and over. Same things. And then they find their new big issue to fucking puck dick over. Soulless. Soulless. Soulless! Godless creatures! Oh, look, we've shut down another road with children! We've shut down a road with children! Oh, look how good we're doing! Oh, look how good we're doing! Oh, we're doing so good, America! Fucking fuck's sake! You chant like soulless, soulless, soulless robots. Let's start marching now. Oh, shut up, Millie Foo. It's an entertainment show. No one cares. I'm playing a character.
Just in case you guys are curious, so all those vehicles up ahead and the...
Now, you fucking don't get that this isn't a bit yet. You're fucking stupid. Whose streets? Faggot streets. All right, Millie Foo, have a great day. Take care. Thanks for the money that I got from your view. I'm gonna go watch basketball. I'll be back. Fuck these kids.
Stay tight!
East Hayes. Quan 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 East Hayes. They're pretty darn cute, aren't they, Shelly? Apologies for the truck. Obstruction. See what I did there? And another obstruction. TT Gully! TT Gully! TT Gully! TT Gully. TT Gully. TT Gully. Everything's getting backed up behind you guys. I'll let them know. Everything's getting like backed up behind you guys, so you might go a little faster. They keep stopping, like almost hitting the cars. There we go. People kept almost running into the cars.
They wanted to call it, and they're still calling it suicide. They're calling it suicide. We know Gully was lit. We know very well. That was murder. Save her name.
TT Gully! TT Gully! TT Gully! TT Gully!
Take it, Gully!
She is so sweet. I love you carrying her. It's so heartwarming.
He did such a good job with the photography. You're everywhere.
Yeah. Less this last week. I had to take a break, but this is my favorite one. So the other ones don't feel safe for me after the cops attacked my car, but
really?
This one, the police attacked my car with me in it.
They did?
Yeah.
When was that?
The 1st, August 1st.
Did they get ruined?
Well, it's fixed now, but they slashed my tires and shattered my rear window.
Do you think they recognized your car?
Well, it said crash. I was in it. I was in the car.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, I was going out at first again. Like, I took 2 days off, and then I was going out again, and my therapist said I just keep re-traumatizing myself.
Yeah.
So, I basically got, like, the full demand from both my naturopath and therapist for, like, you have to take a break. So I haven't been out since last Tuesday.
Okay, yeah.
But this one, like I like to tell people, it's like the training wheels for tour, for protests, you know? Like,
it's so well protected.
It's gentle.
Yeah. It's so well.
I don't have to put on the gas mask. And
totally.
Yeah.
No, I love this.
Okay, I'm going to go catch some of this. Didn't make it tonight either. I had a massage today, so I came out with greasy hair even. But this is my favorite one, so.
Oh. Black lives matter! Black lives matter!
Woo! I love that little guy. Oh.
Can I ask you, are you live streaming?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Zippy Lomax.
Oh, you're Zippy.
I'm Zippy. Love that's you, cute. You, that's you. A cool, sweet reaction. I'm glad.
Love you, Zippy.
Love you. Thank
Sorry
you.
Sorry about your car.
No, that's fine.
Long time follower.
I might take a little longer to. I took a break though. I haven't been out since last Tuesday, so.
Yeah. I've been
paying attention. You. Okay. Well, thank you. Here. There you are. You can go and watch yourself later. Oh, I love that one. That is so beautiful. Did you make that yourself?
Yeah.
I love it.
A few months ago for
oh, and you're wearing I love that shirt. Yes, I love that artist.
That
well, thank you. Thank you for being a good heart. We need more of you. Oh.
Keep doing what you're doing and hang
thank
in
you.
There.
Thank you.
Excuse me. I just have a question. Do you have a live stream or something?
Yep, this is my live stream.
Like, is it public, because I'm okay. The reason why I'm partly asking is because last week I was here and I missed this part of it that I feel like I really should have. I had to like,
yeah,
go, back
go
this, like,
look me up Zippy Lomax or Zipporah Lomax on Facebook.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
cool.
I try to be here every Tuesday.
Cool, yeah. I've been
Destiny
trying to
knows, yeah. It, this is my favorite one.
Found it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of, I mean, I just really
it's easier
like
on the nervous system,
yeah.
And I love kids.
Yeah, for sure.
These kids especially, if we're lucky, they're gonna be the ones.
I hope so. Yeah.
Let's hope. I hope. They
Zippy
give me hope.
Lomax. Yep. I'm just writing down a note and I'll look it up.
It's that, it's there's it no all? W in there. Just it's Lomax.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Cool. I'm easy to find.
Cool.
But, and
thank
I
you.
Think my personal page is Zipporah, which is my full name, but
okay, cool.
It'll pull it up.
Cool. Yeah. Thank you for filming.
Yeah.
It's great to
yeah.
get out there, too. You know, just have
yeah.
more, like,
it's positive. Important.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Okay. Well, as I was trying to say, I'm a little worse for wear. I mean, I had to take a break. I broke out in this crazy rash all over my arms that was like really, really like horrible nerve pain associated with it, like even the air against my skin. Basically, my naturopath thinks that the trauma like sort of delayed, triggered my fibromyalgia. And anyway, I basically had to take a break and I've been sleeping most of the last week. So that's where I've been. Having acupuncture and getting body work done, doing physical therapy, and a lot of sleeping. So that's where I've been. Thanks for joining today. And I doubt that I will be out later because I almost didn't even make it out today. I was so relaxed after my body work. But here I am. I'm glad I came. And you know what I say, wherever you are, whoever you're with, take care of yourselves and each other. Until next time.
From basic training to combat in Vietnam, up the ranks to serve as chairman of the Joint Chiefs.
All right, hold on, hold your high horses. I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady. All right, so the kids' march is over. I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady.
Usually a whole circle of indigenous drummers. Oh, this is cute. Looks like there's little like black youth entrepreneurs.
Hey, what's going on? If you see me, I'm
Hi.
Gonna wait for people to get in here, and then we'll do some Q&A.
It's called the Atom, A-T-O-M. Yeah, it's really cool though.
Okay, no one's live. Do you understand this? There's no one fucking live doing fucking po-trusts. What are we supposed to do? Fine. I'm going to do the only thing I know how to do in situations where there's nothing going on.
I'm asking you to make a donation.
Ah! No!
Official FEC deadline. And if you do, it will be triple matched.
No! All right. Are we still there? It was all that I could do to keep from crying. Sometimes it seems so useless to remain. You don't have to call me Lynn Jennings. You don't have to call me Charlie Pride. You don't have to call me Merle Haggard anymore. Even though on my fighting side, and I'll hang around
as long as you will let me. I'll never find me standing in the rain, but you don't.
Darling, you never even called me by my name. Well, I've heard my name a few times in your phone book.
Hello.
And I've seen it on signs we have played. Wrote that song, and he told me it was the perfect country and western song. Well, I wrote it back a letter and told him it was not the perfect country and western song, because he hadn't said anything about mama, trains, trucks, prison, or even being drunk. Well, Steve sat down and he wrote another verse of the song. Well, he sent it to me. After reading it, I realized that my friend Steve had written the perfect country and western song. I felt obligated to include it on this album. The last verse goes something like this. I was drunk Then my mama got out of prison. And I went to pick her up in the rain. But before I could get to the station in my pickup truck, she got run. Before I give you more of a show, are protests back? They are not. All right. Well, as we wait, any requests out there? We're going to do Danger Zone. And, you know, I'm not happy about this either. I'd rather watch the protests. Oh, shit. I should be watching that basketball game. It's the fourth quarter. God damn it. What am I doing? How do I maintain all of you here? Should have brought the second TV out here. Fuck. All right.
The danger zone. Gonna take you right to the danger zone.
All right, we got time now to set this up. We're going to Seattle. We're gonna have some fun. We're gonna get it in the bum, the bum, the bum, 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 bum.
Highway to the danger zone.
What the fuck? Oh my god, this is gay. This is so gay. The fuck? Oh, it's my knuckles hitting it.
Ultra or whatever, and this is even better than that. Yeah, so.
Fuck!
Yep. Sup, Granny? Sup, Granny's cat, Blaze? Apparently, Granny's cat, Blaze, loves my voice and always, like, goes, oh, hey, look at my hair. Yeah. Don't get iPhone, in my opinion. I hate it. I like Android. Oh, are we near Rebellion Baby? I don't know where Rebellion Baby is. They're kind of like us. They use multiple streamers, so... Savvy, are you going to be here all night? Or as much as you can be? I am seeing the poor connection thing coming up, so I don't know if it's dropping or not, so let me know. Oh, I see, it's Sir Winston. Here for about 2 hours. Okay, any of the... we're going to get a lot of CJ questions, so just will you answer those, because I don't feel like it. And you know exactly what to say. Every other mod, just leave it to Savvy. Rob, you could maybe coordinate with Savvy if you're going to be here all night, and he can tell you what's up. So let's see, Snicker Pie. Thank you, Savvy. I appreciate that a lot. Yeah, there you go. Snicker Pie redeemed compliments, really? Oh, I compliment anybody, but I can compliment anybody with that, right? Yeah, so see, we never have issues in Seattle. Seattle's almost always perfect. Maybe it's because we're based here, or I don't know what. But yeah, so we definitely got Car Brigade getting in place right now. But he might be. I'm not sure. You got to go check. I posted links to his thing on the Facebook and Twitter and the Instagram. Yeah, I put it down to 3,500 because I was noticing that when it was at 6,000, it just kept saying 3,500. So I was like, okay, well, if it's always just going to go 35, I might as well stay. And it's looking pretty good, not having any frame rate drops. I'm wondering if...
How are you doing? How are things looking in Chicago, by the way? I don't keep up as much as I wish I... could, or as much as I wish I did, with the protests in other areas, how's it looking over in Chicago and basically in other areas of the world? How's it looking over where all of you are? I'm sorry, Goddess Sophia. Hey, Buster. Wait, what happened last night? See, I only watched a little bit. Like, I saw where they were. They were at the North Precinct yesterday. Either the North Precinct or the PPA building. I guess it was the police union building, but I try not to, I stop in a little bit, but I try not to go in too much and hang out too much when I'm on my days off, because I just need to try to recuperate and help out my mental health as much as I can. Tulsa, Oklahoma is pretty conservative. It could go blue this year. Well, it's not like the Democrats are progressive. They're not. I mean, they had John Kasich speaking at the DNC. Oh no, was she being pretty toxic or something? When this one woman chanted? I don't know. Yeah, Abe, I am on Discord. You can also send me a whisper if you want. You can send me a whisper. I'll get to it when I can. I'll respond to it when I can. You can definitely respond. You can also, if anybody needs to whisper me, if they're interested in connecting more, if you want access to my Discord community, you can send me a whisper. I'm going to personally vet you myself because we don't want any trolls in there. I do have moderators in my Discord community, but still. Yeah, see, the thing is, hey, Vegan Death Squad. Good to see you. The thing is, truth be told, I didn't care about the DNC. I didn't bother to watch it. I didn't care. I don't really know what happened. Thunder Jackson, I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. I'm not familiar with that incident. Oh, one of the moms was being problematic. Is that what you're telling me? Squeaks, yeah. So I every day have to like decide whether or not I want to protect against impact, or if I want to choose to protect against gassing. And right now I'm choosing impact. I really don't want to get shot in the face. So it's tough. I mean, my lungs are very, very, very important to me. I just don't.
Your lungs can take more punishment than your face.
Yeah, it's tough. I do have a respirator though that I carry with me. Yeah, and I'll feel it out. Like if we start getting gassed, I can throw on my respirator. Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Squeaks. Oh yeah. We actually saw last time I was live. There's this guy with a guitar, and actually somebody clipped it, and there's an interview. I guess you could call it. I just asked him what happened, and they tried to shoot him in the crotch. And they stole his guitar and everything. Oh yeah. Yeah, I probably did miss it, yeah. Sounds like it was interesting. Oh, actually, I posted, y'all can follow me on Twitter if you're interested. !Twitter. My Twitter handle is @AnitaNoelleG. But yeah, there's a clip that I retweeted on there showing that the police clearly stole this guy's guitar. And they also pepper sprayed the hell out of this other dude. CS gas. Does anybody have an idea of what CS gas is? Well, CS gas is tear gas. And it's technically a powder. I don't know if he got his guitar back. I texted him to see if he did. But I haven't heard anything about that. Hey Donovan, good to see you. Oh, Donovan, And don't even worry about it. There's no requirement to ever be here. There's no requirement to be here at all. I'm just happy that you're here now. Don't even worry about it. We've got a lot of mods, and it's okay. It's okay. Don't even worry about it. Yeah. No, yeah, for sure. Thunder Jackson, yeah. I mean, you can straight up die from it. Actually, I mean, you can. If you're asthmatic, you can definitely die from it. Thank you, DCAS. I appreciate that so much. So yeah, I retweet a lot of clips in case I don't catch them. There's a lot of different angles out here. Yeah, there's a lot of press that comes out. Hey, Rad Decay, yeah. It's Mighty Ducks. That's what's going on. You know, I have not seen that movie since I was a kid. Oh, I wear this every night. Dan says, I wear this every night. Well, just about anyway. If I'm not wearing this, I wear my respirator. But lately, this has been what I've decided to wear because I'm afraid of the impact munitions. And I think everybody should have a helmet if they're going to be out here protesting. I really do. And I highly recommend everybody get a hockey helmet specifically. If you're not wearing, if you're not going to wear a respirator. You watch me a lot? Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, yeah, no, Thunder Jackson. Yeah, I haven't had, I never got, a big whiff of it, really, but I've gotten, after it's been, kind of dispersed, and it still sucks. It's really, really tough stuff, yeah. And